PicoScope 6.12.5 is the latest software release for all users of PicoScope PC-based oscilloscopes. This version delivers user interface improvements for touchscreen users and mouse control, including nudge buttons and control settings grids for faster access to primary oscilloscope functions. A new edge count measurement function has been added. Serial protocols have been improved with color-keyed field identifiers. Let's have a look at each one of those in a bit more detail. PicoScope user controls have been enlarged to provide easier access for touchscreen users. That makes life a little bit easier for users who prefer mouse control of the user interface as well. If you're lucky enough to have a PC with a touchscreen, you can also move waveforms vertically, as well as zoom and pan, to reveal specific details of complex signals. The addition of nudge buttons for the main controls, such as time base and vertical settings, is a great time saver for both mouse and touchscreen users. Just tap once to change the ranges. Nudge buttons are ideal if you just want to move up or down to the next range. If, however, you want to jump to a specific time base or voltage range, then the new grid settings function enables faster and easy range selection compared to the previous drop-down lists. A typical example will be changing from, say, 10 nanoseconds per division when viewing a fast noise spike to, say, 20 milliseconds per division to see if the signal has any 50 or 60 hertz noise. On a traditional oscilloscope, this involves turning the knob over 20 clicks. With PicoScope, it is just 2 clicks of the mouse or taps of the touchscreen. A frequent customer request has been for PicoScope to automatically count the number of edges in a waveform. With the new edge count measurement, you can choose between rising, falling, or both rising and falling edges. Measurements can be made on all data or just between the rulers. In 6.12, we have made further improvements to the serial protocol decoders. The most obvious of those are the color-keyed field identifiers. Each decoded field type in the graph display is displayed in a unique color, which helps users to focus on the relevant data in large and complex data sets. In the CAN example shown here, the message ID frames are shaded orange. DLC is green, data is blue, and the cyclical redundancy check is sky blue. And the frame timing is indicated in indigo. Notice also the stuffed bits that are shown in grey. PicoScope includes decoders for 16 different serial protocols. Shown here are I2C, CAN, SPI, and SENT. In all cases, each field type has a unique color for ease of interpretation. To get the latest version of PicoScope, go to our homepage at picotech.com and click on Downloads. The list of available downloads for each Pico product is shown. Next, click on PicoScope 6.12 Stable and a pop-up window will appear with a button to download. Once you have clicked this, the software installation package will be downloaded. And when complete, click on the file and follow the on-screen instructions. Whether you're buying your first PicoScope or you've had yours for 3, 5, or even 10 years, you'll be pleased to know that each new release of the PicoScope software is supplied free of charge. All the new features described in this video are included for all PicoScope models, past and present.